Sailing into a new port has always been a thrill that over 28 million people paid $27 billion to enjoy in 2020. The attraction of a floating palace with gourmet food, lively entertainment, and feeling like royalty is only the frosting on the cake after the excitement of exploring a new port. Recently, I posted an unscientific poll question on Facebook Norwegian Cruise Line Latitude's member page. I asked how many would love to live on a cruise ship that only costs $25,000 per person per year. The results were overwhelmingly in favor of the idea. Within 24 hours, 159 people had voted. 97% said they would love to travel the world on a ship. It's not a new idea. In 1869, Mark Twain and some wealthy buddies cruised to Europe on their private ship and explored the wonders of the Mediterranean. Twain wrote about his adventures in the book entitled Innocents Abroad. There are many around-the-world cruises available. The longest voyage is 180 days and costs over $126,000 per person. CruiseEasy.com looked into living on a cruise ship for a year and came up with the cost of $174,791.46 for two people in one cabin. There are several cruise companies where you can purchase your cabin like a condo and cruise year-round. However, the average cabin costs in the many millions, and there is an annual fee per person that is charged to cover operating expenses. The world and Storylines are the leaders in this concept. Storylines' new billion-dollar ship sets sail this year. The world has been cruising since 2002. The dream of living on a cruise ship that visits ports around the world is an expensive one. The most affordable is Storylines, where purchasing a cabin costs millions and the annual fee is over $60,000 per couple. If you don't have a partner, it is still $60,000 a year. It is my vision and research-based proposal to create a residential community on a cruise ship that travels all over the world. This community will be made up of upper middle class people who have the desire to see the world. The name of the company that will make this possible is Atlas Life Adventures. This is my proposal. The goal of the company is to convert a cruise ship into a floating residential community of stateroom owners. In many respects, the ship would be a floating condominium. The ship would travel around the world, visiting a wide variety of ports. But unlike cruise lines like Norwegian or Carnival, the ship would stay for more than a day in any one port. For example, a port like Santorini would warrant a stay of about 3 days, but a stay at New York City would justify at least a month. Cruise lines design their itineraries to sound as exciting as possible, and so include as many ports as possible. The negative side of their business model is that passengers barely get a taste of what is available to experience in any one port. One cannot know places like Athens, London, or Rome in a day. We have analyzed one popular Mediterranean cruise that had 7 ports in 7 days. 57% of the cruise was at sea, and only 43% was in a port. Most of your cruise dollar goes to the cost of moving the ship. With longer port stays, we dramatically lower the cost of travel while maximizing your experience. Their 7-day cruise would be over 30 days on our floating community. Our vision of a floating residential community would be to offer many enrichment opportunities, both on board the ship and at the current port. A complete complement of services and spaces on the ship would create a small town feeling. Community involvement would be essential in helping decide which ports to visit and for how long. Yearly fees would be based on the size of the stateroom and whether it is an inside, ocean view, balcony style, or deluxe version, plus the number of occupants. Guests of stateroom owners would be charged a daily fee. There would be a tour department to arrange tours of ports. An entertainment department would arrange for daily activities, including performances and entertainment, taking advantage of both onboard talent and local talent. Currently in the market, there are several companies which offer full-time cruising with many exciting onboard activities. As mentioned before, they are Storylines and The World. Storyline is building a megaship that will cost almost $1 billion. Most of their cabins go for millions of dollars, and their annual fees run over about $5,000 a month per couple. The World also offers living at sea by purchasing a cabin on their ship, The World. Cabins are priced from $2 million to $15 million on The World. Our goal is to offer a much more affordable experience by refurbishing a used cruise ship. It would be advantageous to buy a cruise ship that is still in service, as licensing may be easier to transfer or renew. Maintenance would also be current on the ship since it is in service. Our goal is to offer a range of cabins from $250,000 up to $1 million, with the average cabin priced at around $500,000. Our goal is to keep the monthly fee to no more than $2,500 per person per month. We believe there's a huge market for an affordable residential ships that offer a lifestyle of travel, education, and fellowship that presents the wonders of the world to the middle class. Ultimately, we can see a fleet of ships cruising the world. Here are some broad details of Atlas Life's adventures for ship. The plan to buy a used cruise ship for around $30 million to $120 million and then spend a multi-million dollar budget to refurbish the ship to more modern standards and create the spaces we need. As mentioned before, it would be advisable to purchase a ship still in service. The target population would be people more interested in a travel lifestyle of comfort without the extreme offerings such as water slides, racetracks, climbing walls, and other extreme sports. Pools, hot tubs, and a health club, along with other leisure activities, will be provided with various membership levels. Example, one day a week, access to unlimited. Classes of various topics will be developed for all to enjoy. An art/craft center will be created on board, offering free classes in painting, sculpture, ceramics, photography, filmmaking, quilting, sewing, and other art classes will be offered. An additional fee for art supplies may be charged. Shopping will be aimed at daily living needs and limited gifts. The shopping department would also offer special orders and coordinate delivery to the ship. Restaurants and bars will be exceptional. Gambling will be available per rules of each country and open sea rules. Winning percentages will be generous, but still in favor of the ship. Channels such as HBO, Disney, BBC, and Roku would be offered as part of the yearly fee. Wi-Fi would be available on an unlimited basis and be included by the yearly fee. A legal department would be established on board and available to owners and guests for a fee. The legal department will offer basic legal tasks such as wills, real estate sales, and any port legal issues for crew or owners. An insurance department would offer home insurance for cabin owners as well as medical insurance. Making sure all owners and guests have medical insurance will be part of their duties. All owners and guests with their own insurance would be responsible to file for their own claims. Small pets would be allowed based on the size of the stateroom. A doggy park would be constructed that would allow dogs to socialize and do their business. A veterinarian would be made available and basic coverage would be offered for a fee. The vet doctor would be responsible to make sure all pets have all necessary vaccinations and offer pet pharmacy services. Limited short-term pet sitting would be available based on the number of days required. The veterinarian department would determine which ports will allow pets to go ashore. Pet grooming services would be provided for a fee. Please note, the option for pets has not been explored as being legally possible as of the date of this proposal. The shopping department would also offer special orders and coordinate how they would be delivered to the ship. The entertainment department would offer a wide variety of live entertainment as well as current motion pictures, while in port, local musicians and entertainers would be brought on board. All onboard entertainment would be covered by the yearly fee to stateroom owners and guests. Laundry services would be covered by a yearly fee, but limited to certain amounts per person. Extra laundry would be fee-based. Dry cleaning would be offered in certain ports through the shopping department. A community kitchen where groups could prepare food and dine would be available. Arrangements for fresh local produce and meats would allow those who like to cook to take advantage of the current port's bounty. Environmental concerns. One important aim during the refurbishment of the used ship is to make it as environmentally neutral as possible. Exploring the use of low sulfur fuels and biofuels, as well as adding solar cells that generate electricity for the ship, will lower the ship's carbon footprint. Cold ironing is the concept of using shore-based power when in port, and therefore being able to shut down all engines, thereby reducing pollution. We would make sure that we can do this in as many ports as possible. In other ports where shore power is not possible due to being anchored, most of the engines will not be needed, and this will lessen the fuel needs by 85%. Treatment of gray and black water will be held to the highest standards possible. Plastic usage will be very restricted. Most wines and beers will be purchased by the barrel or cask in order to limit the amount of glass that needs to be recycled. All efforts would be made to recycle all solid waste generated by the ship. Year-round cruising. I believe there is a huge market to tap for catering to the upper middle class. Sample ship financial breakdown. For our sample ship, we are using NCL Norwegian Spirit, vessel IM0914065, Bahama flagged, registered in Nassau. The Spirit was built in 1989 for $380 million and refitted in 2020 for $100 million. The Spirit is 75,904 gross tons, 880 feet long, with a beam of 121 feet. It has 1,006 cabins in 27 grades. That includes 2 owner cabins, 18 extra large cabins, 382 balcony cabins, 222 ocean view cabins, and 384 inside cabins. It runs on 4 14-cylinder medium-speed diesel engines. Each engine consumes 903 gallons of fuel an hour at the 85% load. Cruising with all four engines at 85% rate consumes 86,688 gallons of fuel a day. In port with a ship docked, only internal power for human comforts are needed and fuel needs are 13,000 gallons a day. If cold ironing, the ship would not use any fuel. Guest capacity is measured by a standard 2 people per cabin. Spirit has, at 2 per cabin, has a capacity of 2,016 people. Some cabins can take more than 2 people, and in the case of Spirit, it can hold up to 2,414 people. We will base our numbers on 2 people per cabin. As mentioned earlier, there are 2 owner's cabins, which would go for $1 million. The 18 extra large cabins would go for $650,000. The 382 balcony cabins would be $450,000. The 222 ocean view cabins would be $325,000. And the 384 inside cabins would be $250,000 per cabin. If we sold all the cabins, that would come to a total of $352,750,000. More than enough to buy and refurbish a used cruise ship. With $352,750,000 gross sales, the level of profit for the initial backers is considerably high even after factoring in $30 to $100 million for a used ship and a refurbishment budget of $100 million. Annual fees would be based on two people per cabin. Each cabin type would have a different base fee. For instance, the owner's cabin would be $25,000 per year per person. Extra large cabins, $24,000 per year per person. Balcony cabins, $22,500 per year per person. Ocean view cabins, $21,500 per year per person. An inside cabin would be $20,440 per year per person. Based on that, the conservative yearly annual fee would come to $43,397,920. Note, all cabins will have to pay a minimum annual fee for two people. Additional cabin occupants would be charged a prorated fee based on the number of days stayed on the ship. Thus, the annual fee total is on the conservative low side. Additional revenues would be for services or products not included in the annual fee and therefore hold additional profit potential. Owners do have the right to sublet their cabins through our rental department, which can be used to offset their annual fee and possibly earn owners a profit beyond their annual fee. Conclusion: the concept of Atlas Life Adventures has an opportunity to create a very profitable business model, one which has a bigger potential based on eventually fielding a fleet of ships. There are far more moderately wealthy people who could afford buying into our vision than those who can afford Storyline or the world's residential ship concept. Thank you for listening to our proposal.